Hi everybody, welcome. Today I am sharing with you how I have made this DIY hot cocoa station for the Christmas season. So I love drinking hot chocolate on a cool or cold day, and so I thought it'd be really fun to have this out on display instead of tucked into a cupboard for this time of year. So I'm just gonna share with you how I have used items I had on hand, some vintage pieces, thrifted pieces that I already had, to make this a very simple and affordable DIY cocoa station. So, of course, the first thing I had to find was something to put everything in. And what better piece than a rustic old crate? This is an old Dr. Pepper crate that I found free, actually. And I just love how it looks. It fits perfectly underneath my cabinets. And I think it's just the right space. It doesn't take up so much counter space either, that it fits right under there really well. So then I also have these vintage apothecary jars. I think some of them are vintage, I'm not sure. And then this snack tub glass piece that holds my hot cocoa as well. And then my cinnamon and nutmeg spice jars I already had that go with all my other spice jars in my spice cabinet. And I just pulled them out. So to begin with, of course, you have to have marshmallows and you have to have candy canes. And what better candy canes than the mini ones? I love the mini candy canes because it doesn't feel like you're having too much sugar, but it'd be just right to hang over your mug. And then it was time to put my hot cocoa in the container. And I think this is a good tip. Have a little scoop to put in your hot cocoa container. That way people aren't looking for spoons, or you could display spoons out if you have some fun wooden spoons or Christmas spoons that you want to put out for people to scoop out. But I just honestly had this plastic, like 2 tablespoon measuring piece from something else I already had that I just washed out and used for my hot cocoa, which makes it about the perfect amount, honestly, for a cup of hot chocolate. And my little hot cocoa sign is on a little chalkboard circle tag that I found at the Dollar Tree for, it's like a pack of 5 or something for a dollar, and I thought that would work well. It's not too big and it fits right on my crate, actually just tucked right in there with the twine. And I wrote it handwritten, so nothing super fancy, but I just think it looks super adorable. And then of course you have to have ribbons. You probably noticed that on my hot chocolate canister, this Christmas tree white and gold ribbon. That was a Dollar Tree find a couple years ago that I had still on hand. And then this little gold ribbon, I just love that on a little jar. I think that's a perfect size, not too big, but just adds that nice touch of Christmas. Then of course added some of my cinnamon and nutmeg and put those up there. And then I started displaying it on my shelf. But first I added a piece of greenery from a tree I clipped. So after a couple weeks, I'll have to put a new one out because the needles will start falling. But I just think that's really a nice natural element to add. And then I used these Christmas balls. And if you watched my Christmas kitchen decorating video, you saw I used those throughout some of my kitchen in the decorating. They were from the Dollar Tree again a couple years ago. And just very simple, just tucked them right in there, just 2 of them to add that pop of color. And I think that's just such a beautiful way to add decoration without being overbearing. And then of course, some people like to use straws, so I have these metal straws and put it in a mason jar with a ribbon, of course, just on the other side of my coffee dispenser. And this is all displayed underneath my coffee tea cupboard. So if someone didn't want hot chocolate, of course they could have tea or coffee or whatever else I have up there for them to choose from, cider. So that is how I have made this. And of course, super affordable, just really fun little vignette for me to have when company comes over, or just for my husband and I to have as well. So I, of course, have to enjoy my own hot chocolate as well. Some marshmallows, add a little touch of cinnamon and that peppermint stick. Maybe not the peppermint and cinnamon, but such a wonderful treat on a cold wintry day. So I hope you enjoyed this and hope you can make a little hot chocolate station or coffee station for your home for this season. Hope you're having a blessed and wonderful Thanksgiving weekend, and I will talk with you in the next video. Bye.